नमस्ते, हेलो एंड वेलकम टू गांव कैफे। गांव कनेक्शन के गांव कैफे में आप सभी का स्वागत है। 5 दिन की ही देरी से ही सही, परंतु मॉनसून ने जो है पूरे देश को कवर कर लिया है। नॉर्मली मॉनसून कवर्स इंटायर इंडिया बाय जुलाई 8, बट दिस ईयर इट वाज डिलेड बाय अबाउट 5 डेज एंड इट कवर्ड द इंटायर कंट्री ओनली ऑन जुलाई ऑफ 13। सिचुएशन वॉज वेरी ग्रिम इन डेली एंड यू माइट हैव सीन ऑल ओवर सोशल मीडिया, पीपल इन डेली वर रियली रियली डेस्परेट फॉर रेन्स। एंड दिस ईयर द रेन्स अराइव्ड ओनली ऑन द जुलाई 13th, विच is almost 15 days later than the normal arrival of monsoon in Delhi, which is on June 27th. Apart from this, there are a lot of other interesting facts, information about monsoon this year, because of which in today's Gaon Cafe, we have a very special guest joining us with whom we will discuss about monsoon 2021. 6 weeks of the monsoon are over, so we will try and make some sense of what has happened so far, what lies ahead for the country. So let me welcome our guest, Sridhar Balasubramaniam. Professor Sridhar is the associate professor with Mechanical Engineering Department of India Institute of Technology, Bombay, IIT Bombay. He's also the adjunct faculty member at IDE Climate Studies at IIT Bombay. Welcome to Gaon Cafe, Professor Sridhar. First, the biggest question for you: what has happened to our monsoon this year? From 19th of June, we understand that the monsoon was in a break phase and it only revived recently and it has arrived in Delhi. So if you can just tell us what exactly went wrong or what happened with the monsoon.
Yeah, first of all, thank you, Nidhi, for inviting. It's always a pleasure to be in the studio and talking to you. As you rightly said, the monsoon has been behaving very, it is a roller coaster ride as always. And this year was no different. It had a lot of exciting moments as well as depressing moments, especially for Delhi and other parts of North India. So before I focus on what happened between June 19th to July 12th, let us just take a little step back and understand how the monsoon features behave. So what exactly happens with the monsoon? So this is going to be slightly basic. So what exactly happens is during the peak summer months, near the equator, your monsoon currents start strengthening. So they start gaining energy slowly and slowly near the equator. And anything near the equator has the tendency to move up. So equator is like a wall. It just pushes things up in the northern hemisphere and down in the southern hemisphere. And since we are in the northern hemisphere, we will talk about India. So this monsoon currents, then they slowly start propagating up north from the equator. And as it starts this journey, it splits, the monsoon currents split into two branches. One is the Arabian Sea branch and the other is the Bay of Bengal branch. So as you know, India is one of the unique geographical locations which is surrounded by two basins. That is why we are always in the hub of extreme weather events. And in Indian Ocean is one of the most mysterious basins, given the Arabian Sea dynamics as well as Bay of Bengal dynamics. So the monsoon current split into two branches. And these two branches then slowly propagate, where the Arabian Sea branch covers the monsoon on the west coast of India and parts of the central India, especially the western central India, which includes Karnataka, Telangana, Marathwada, Vidarbha, Madhya Pradesh, and all those places. Whereas the Bay of Bengal branch slowly percolates and propagates, the monsoon propagates into Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, Odisha, West Bengal, Northeast, and all those places. The region which is above central India, which is the Northwest India, is a very tricky situation, because both these branches should combine so that the monsoon will propagate into Uttar Pradesh, Haryana, Delhi, parts of Rajasthan, and up above into Jammu and Kashmir. So this year what had happened was the Bay of Bengal branch was quite active. However, the Arabian Sea branch lost the momentum. So itna zyada us energy nahi tha. Arabian Sea branch have that much energy. So okay, after June 15th, it just lost, the Arabian Sea branch was very inactive. And that's the reason it was kind of a make or break situation, because IMD had expected that monsoon may reach Delhi on June 16th. And obviously, because they were expecting that the Arabian Sea branch and Bay of Bengal branch will converge over Delhi or close to Delhi, and the monsoon onset may happen, because models were expecting that. But it did not happen. The Arabian Sea branch lost its energy. And once that happened, we went into a break phase, because the Bay of Bengal branch of monsoon also reached the foothills of Himalayas. So whenever the monsoon reaches the foothills of Himalayas, the monsoon comes into a break phase. Matlab, the rains will reduce throughout the country, except for Bihar, Uttar Pradesh, and Northeast India.
Northeast, right.
So that happened around June 19th or 20th, where the monsoon was very weak. And both the branches of monsoon kind of degenerated. Okay. So once the monsoon degenerates, then you have to wait for at least 10 days or maybe 2 weeks for the fresh monsoon pulse to come in from the equator and slowly again move upwards. All right. And that is when again the Bay of Bengal branch and the Arabian Sea branch will again re-energize. So that started happening in the around the first week of July or near July 10th.
Okay.
And that resulted in the onset of monsoon over North India, especially over Delhi. Mm-hmm. And it also helped in revival of the monsoon.
Okay. So can you tell us, Professor Vidha, what exactly, like when you said from 15th of March, it lost its energy. What happened with this Arabian Sea branch? And is this kind of a 3 weeks break phase a normal thing to happen?
Yeah, so 15th of June is when the Arabian Sea branch started losing its energy. So to answer the second, I will try to answer it in parts. I will answer the second question first. Break phase in monsoon is very common. So it is because monsoon is like a system. It is not like a perennial system. It needs to energize, and it will lose it because it dumps all the rain over central India or parts of Northeast India, West Coast, everywhere it dumps the rain, and then it has lost its energy, or it has lost its the strength that it has gained. So now, once that happens, it typically finds its solace near foothills of Himalayas. That's why it goes and settles near foothills of Himalayas, and that's how we know that monsoon has come to a break phase. And then there is re-energization of monsoon has to happen, but that depends on multiple factors, especially how the Arabian Sea and the Bay of Bengal is behaving. So the ocean content or the ocean heat content or the performance of the ocean is very, very crucial for monsoon to re-energize.
Okay.
So that is one thing.
Okay.
So what happened this year, at least in after June 15th, what happened was there is this feature known as Indian Ocean Dipole, which is in a very basic scientific terms, it is the difference in the temperatures between the Arabian Sea and the Bay of Bengal near the equator. Okay, so if you look at the temperature difference between the Arabian Sea basin and the Bay of Bengal basin, you can kind of see whether the Indian Ocean Dipole is active or it is inactive. And the Indian Ocean Dipole being active plays a very, very important role for the Arabian Sea branch to get activated.
Achha, okay.
And after July 15th, what happened was the Indian Ocean Dipole went into a negative phase. So negative phase of Indian Ocean Dipole is not favorable for the monsoon to strengthen.
And I think, jaise ki humare darshakon ko pata hi hoga ki monsoon ko jo hai Bharat ka finance minister bhi kaha jata hai, kyunki hamara jo pura agriculture hai kafi had tak almost 51% jo hamara net sown area hai farming ka Bharat mein, wo abhi bhi barish ke upar, barish ke pani pe nirbhar karta hai, kyunki irrigation ki facilities hamare sabhi kisano ke paas nahi hai. Aur jo sarkari aankde bhi abhi tak hame ye bata rahe hain ki monsoon ka ye jo break phase aaya hai kareeb 3 hafte ka, isse jo hai खरीफ सोइंग के ऊपर भी काफी इंपैक्ट पड़ा है. तो प्रोफेसर श्रीधर, इफ वी आस्क यू द नेक्स्ट अटैच्ड क्वेश्चन वुड बी दैट आल्सो आईएमडी इशूड अ स्टेटमेंट सेइंग द एरर, यू नो, इन द दे यूज द वर्ड एरर इन फोरकास्टिंग ऑफ द ऑनसेट ऑफ मॉनसून इन दिल्ली. पीपल कीप जोकिंग पीपल की एक मेकिंग फन थी, आईएमडी ने बोला है तो बारिश तो पक्का नहीं होगी, यू नो दिस हैज बिकम लाइक अ थिंग. कैन यू ऑल्सो टेल अस हाउ चैलेंजिंग फोरकास्टिंग मॉनसून इज, एंड देर आर ऑलवेज चांसेस फॉर दीज एरर्स, एंड यू नो कैन यू जस्ट एक्सप्लेन टू अस व्हाट आर द चैलेंजेस व्हेन वन इज फोरकास्टिंग मॉनसून?
Yeah, absolutely. I think I would love to talk about that because it's a very pressing issue, and you have rightly kind of brought it up. So before I get into the issues with monsoon forecasting, I would like to make a statement that we always use this word IMD has got it wrong, and the wrong word is an extremely exaggerated or it's an overstatement. The reason I'm saying that is because when you say wrong, it means that it is bakwas, right? That's what that's the kind of connotation that wrong, the word wrong has. I mean, if you look at the dictionary, that is what it has. The meaning of it is that. But that's not what IMD's forecasts are. Okay, so the fundamental problem is that we are always in this kind of a traditional binary approach of metric where we just tag things as wrong or right, or good or bad, okay? And that's not how it works when it comes to weather. We have to have a out-of-box kind of an approach, and we should actually be looking at reliability. So reliable is the word that we should be using, because reliable has multiple levels: high reliability, medium reliability, low reliability. And reliability doesn't mean wrong, because it might have rained in some place, but not with the intensity that that IMD had predicted, okay? So reliability is the word that I think we should be using when it comes to forecasts, and we should shun away from the or ye wrong word use nahi karna chahiye. It's a completely overstatement or exaggeration of the forecast.
Okay,
that is the first point that I would like to make. The second point is if you want to understand the challenges with the monsoon, there are multiple challenges, but I would just like to highlight maybe two or three. Indian monsoon is one of those very rare systems that has teleconnection. Teleconnection matlab it has bearing on a very large spatial and temporal scale. So for instance, something in the Pacific can affect our monsoon. Pacific is 2000 kilometers away from the Indian Ocean. Kuch Pacific mein ho raha hai, that can impact the monsoon. Atlantic, which is again very far away from our Indian basin, wahan pe kuch ho raha hai, it will affect the monsoon. Heat waves in US or Canada, that can also have a bearing on the monsoon. Some melting of ice in the Arctic, that can have the bearing on monsoon. Melting of ice in Antarctic, that can have a bearing on monsoon. So this monsoon is like a central system which has connections from all these multiple systems, okay?
Right.
And predicting that is a challenge, and not only India, internationally, everybody accepts that monsoon is one of the most difficult things to predict. All right.
Okay.
Sorry, that is one point. The second point is, okay, people will say we have global models, which are dynamical models. Why can't they predict monsoon? So global models are good because they take into account all the things that are happening in all these basins, but they have limitations. One of the limitations is that they initialize or usko jab start karte hain, when you start the global models, you have to start with some initial condition. So usko pehle temperature present. Aaj, let's say at 4:54 p.m. on July 14th, abhi ka temperature, pressure, wind, moisture, what is this value right now? That has to be fed appropriately.
Okay.
And even a single change, even a single mistake in that can result in a erroneous error, because all these variables, the meteorological variables that we are talking about, have a non-linear relationship. Non-linear relationship matlab, you invest in a mutual fund, you know ki after 3 years you are going to get this return, but you invest in a stock, you don't know what is the return, correct?
Right.
This is exactly the non-linearity that exists. So if you have a slight 1% error in the moisture or in the wind or in the temperature during the initialization of this global model, that is going to be a completely different result.
Okay.
That is one problem. The second problem is that you these models take a lot of time to run. So you cannot run it every hour or every minute. You can only run it once in 6 hours or once in 12 hours. That's why all the outputs are every 6 hours or every 12 hours, depending on the global model.
And but these models are run on supercomputers.
Yes,
these are all run on supercomputers. Okay.
Right, right. Which are massive supercomputers, which on which these models run. Now the issue is that abhi monsoon mein slight change. Abhi, let's say the models have run and they have given the output, but there was a slight change in some dynamic. Let us say the Western Ghats. I'm just giving a very exaggerated example. There was something that happened in the Western Ghats in a zone. Which was not predicted by the model. So that can completely change the scenario of how much rainfall is going to happen in Mumbai or in Pune or in Marathwada.
Okay.
And the model has already run and it has given the output and it doesn't know that that particular change has happened.
Okay.
So that change can only be reflected in the next run, which is probably after 12 hours or after 6 hours or whatever. And we are kind of always very anxious, and we say that IMD has said it will rain, so we always look up at the sky and say abhi barish hone wala, and it doesn't rain, or it rains in a very scanty amount, or bahut kam rainfall hua, and then we start making conclusions that monsoon has failed or IMD's forecast has failed. It has not failed because they were not, it's not because they said that it will rain. They looked at all these conditions and then only they said that it will rain, but some conditions change, so you better wait for the next forecast or the next advisory before making any conclusion.
Okay. So basically it's a very very complex system of forecasting, and it's not as easy as saying कि कल बारिश हो जाएगा, या अगर 15 तारीख को बारिश आ रही है तो 15 को ही आएगी, खासकर कि मॉनसून, एज फार एज यू नो मॉनसून इज कंसर्न, लाइक यू आर ट्राइंग टू एक्सप्लेन,
राइट? और अदर इश्यू विद मॉनसून इज दैट इट मे रेन एट नाइट, बट वी कैनॉट से, सो पीपल वॉन्ट एट वॉट टाइम इट विल रेन. इट इज एक्सट्रीमली डिफिकल्ट टू से एट वॉट टाइम इट विल रेन. यू कैनॉट से दैट 12 बजे बारिश होने वाला है एट एन इंटेंसिटी ऑफ 100 mm. इट्स इम्पॉसिबल. It may rain maybe at night 100 mm, so that gap of 6 or 12 hours when the rainfall has happened, that also public kind of doesn't realize that itself is a very good prediction, but they again try to look at the fact that you said it will rain in the morning but it has rained in the night, so but it did rain, right? I mean that itself is a huge barrier that we have resolved as far as monsoon is concerned.
Right. And we also have a monsoon mission going on. So I guess with time, with years, it will get better, the whole forecasting system. With this, Professor Sridhar, if we see the last 2-3 days, we've had like massive flash floods, whether it is in Himachal Pradesh, Dharamshala, we saw, pictures of rivers completely flooded and gushing down. Similar visuals are coming from J&K, where a lot of districts have received many times above normal rainfall. How normal or how okay is it to have such extreme rainfall in a short duration of time?
So that's actually another interesting question. So it is, I think during monsoon, nothing is abnormal is what I feel. What I mean is, in the sense that it's I'm pretty sure that it must have happened some years back. It's just that we don't recall it, or every time it happens we try to associate it with the first time it has happened. With monsoon, these kind of extremities are expected. That is the nature of monsoon or over the years it has become extreme. Maybe it was not so extreme 20 years back or 30 years back. Now the extremity has increased, but even 20-30 years back, I'm sure that there would have been instances where there would have been heavy rainfall in hilly regions of Himachal or Jammu and Kashmir. So this is not something that is abnormal. I think the abnormality is because of the fact that it led to a massive flash floods, which led to probably loss of property and little bit of loss of life, which is quite disheartening. So what happened? If I take 30 seconds to sure. just talk about Dynamics. So we all knew that the onset is going to happen in Delhi and other parts of India. So the monsoon will cover the entire country around July 12th or 13th, which happened. So whenever such kind of propagation of monsoon happens, we also need to look at one other aspect, which is the westerly winds, the winds which are coming, especially for North India, winds which are coming from the west.
Okay.
And so those winds are dry because they are dry in the sense usme moisture level kam rehta hai because they are only crossing land. They don't cross
okay.
sea because right. it is all land. You have Pakistan, you have Afghanistan, and you have Ukraine and all those places. So right. it is mostly dry air.
Okay.
And the easterly, the winds coming from the east, from the Bay of Bengal, they carry a lot of moisture. So then whenever they collide, they form something known as a dry line, which is a very in meteorology it is a recipe for disaster, because when the moist air and dry air meet, then they lead to formation of massive clouds, and those massive clouds have a tendency to drop a lot of rain in a very localized space.
Okay.
So that is what had happened. Like these two winds, these two dry air and moist air met somewhere near Himachal. They led to formation of these massive clouds, and they almost dropped maybe I think 50 mm or 60 mm in 1 hour or 2 hours, or maybe 100 mm in 2 hours, which is
right.
which is not cloudburst. I think cloudburst definition is slightly different, but it is still very, very heavy rainfall. And added to that, the hilly regions, water has to always flow down so that the slope increases the velocity with which the water is coming down. And that leads to these kind of disasters.
Do you think, Professor, that also the rainfall patterns as far as monsoon is concerned are changing in India? Because some of the studies are pointing out that in central India, rainfall is increasing or somewhere. Do you think rainfall patterns are changing? And is there any link to climate change?
Yes, so absolutely, I think rainfall patterns have changed, because I have also come across many research papers that show that the rainfall patterns have changed over central India and the Indo-Gangetic plains. These two regions, I think the focus is more because of the agricultural hub of these are the agricultural hub of India. So rainfall pattern has changed. And if I want to point out two things which has changed, one is the active and the break phase. So active phase is when the monsoon is very energetic, so it gives rainfall to almost entire country, which is the phase right now we are going through. July 13th onwards till July 18th or 19th is the active phase of monsoon.
Okay.
And then there is a break phase. So over the years, what I have at least seen is that the active phases are reducing and the break phases are extending, so you are getting okay. prolonged break phases,
dry phase
in monsoon. And you are getting shorter active phases in monsoon, which is very bad for many things, especially agriculture, because the amount of rainfall is not changing. The amount of rainfall is still, let us say, x millimeters, but the period in which you are getting that x millimeter is changing. So you are getting that same amount of rainfall in shorter time period, which is only possible if there is a very, very heavy episodes of rain in 1 day or 2 day, correct?
Right.
2 day. And then this is followed by a long spell of no rains or very minimal rains or almost bahut hi kam rainfall ho raha hai. And that pattern is not very good for agriculture. That is one thing that has changed. So that rainfall pattern is changing, and extremities of rainfall is also changing. And the second question is climate change. Of course, climate change has a lot of bearing, because how will this happen? Because your ocean is heating up. Ocean is one of the most important drivers of monsoon. If your oceans heat up, they supply a lot of energy, and because of they give a lot of moisture. As they give a lot of moisture has to come towards the land, and the moisture gets dumped over the land, and then again the ocean has to again come back to a energetic state. So the cycle repeats, and that cycle okay. gets disrupted because of climate change.
Just last question, Professor Sridhar, if you can tell us, 6 weeks of the southwest monsoon season are over. How do you see the rest of the period now? I mean, what it is, are we going to have a normal rainfall this monsoon, above normal? How do you see the next week of next few weeks of the monsoon?
Yeah, it's a tricky question, but yeah, whatever I'm going to say is all my personal opinion.
Absolutely.
Because already we have IMD has given its verdict, so of course we should take that as the holy grail and give that lot of attention. So I have been kind of closely watching what is happening to the long range events in the ocean, and I spoke about the Indian Ocean Dipole, which is one of the key parameters. The other parameter in the Pacific is the El Nino. I'm sure everybody has heard about this term El Nino. So broadly speaking, these two are the drivers of monsoon on a longer scale. Shorter scale, there are many other factors.
Right.
If you want to look at a long scale, long time scale, then these two are the kind of the major drivers. And if you look at the Indian Ocean Dipole, it is, I think, even a lot of agencies have already said that negative IOD chances are increasing. So negative IOD chances increasing means Arabian Sea is not going to be that active.
Right.
So Arabian Sea is going to be sluggish. Uska wo thoda lazy hone wala hai. Bay of Bengal branch will maintain its intensity. Not a problem there. So given this scenario, and other thing is El Nino is neutral. So ENSO is not favorable and not unfavorable. So it is maintaining a neutral state. So given this situation going ahead, I feel that we have to be on the close watch for maybe some below normal rains over the west coast of India as well as the northwest of India.
Okay.
And maybe even north of India, because Arabian Sea branch plays a very important role when it comes to North India, Northwest India, and parts West Coast and South Peninsular India as well. So overall, it may end up normal.
Right.
But if you talk about district-wise, then western parts and northwestern parts may end up in deficit, slight deficit, or maybe some major deficit. Already Gujarat and Rajasthan are in a large deficit. So I mean, the outlook is not very promising, is what I would say, going ahead into August and September. If negative IOD develops, if the IOD becomes negative, then the picture is slightly grim for the western parts of India. Central India, not so much, because Central India, Bay of Bengal branch also plays a role in Central India. So I'm hoping that the monsoon core zones, where the agriculture activity is going on, the monsoon will end up in normal, is what I feel. Maybe not above normal, but normal.
Right. Thank you so much, Professor Sridhar. That was really informative. And I think we wanted to have you on our show because we really want people to understand the basics of monsoon, because it affects us all. And, you know, sometimes a lot of times people think monsoon is just too complex for people to understand. But I think if we interact more with people like you and other scientists, it's always good to understand, you know, this has been happening for millions of years. Every year monsoon comes, gives us so much of rainfall, and then goes away. Next year it again comes back. So I think it's a lovely phenomena which we all look forward to. And it's always lovely to understand it from you. So thank you so much for joining us on Gao Cafe. We look forward to having you on other shows as well. Thank you, Professor.
Thank you so much, Nidhi. It was my pleasure. And as you rightly said, the monsoon dynamics are very interesting. And I hope that many people will read up and they will also try to have a little bit more open mind towards the IMD alerts and IMD advisories. So thank you so much once again.